Welcome back, guys, to Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask with your host, Illizandri, because today I'm suffering from a cold nicely this week. I had the height of the cold yesterday, so I'm sounding a little bit better today. I couldn't do any commentary for a while. So I've just given you a bit of an ill commentary, so if I sound really stupid or odd, that's why. But of course, daily Let's Plays on this channel, so I have to keep Zelda up and running. And first off today, we will be looking for Kamaro, a guy who supposedly dancing around somewhere up here in the northern stretches, the northern reaches of the highlands. Let us find him. If it is a him or her, Kamaro. Let's put a lot of this knowledge that you guys are giving me in the comments to use. For example, the one where the bomb mask can be used safely behind a shield, which I did not know, but I have known for a while because you guys have said, but because of various things going on this month, I haven't been keeping up to date with my videos, up to date with your comments, but now we are at that kind of level. So welcome back, as it were. Kamaro, I am no longer part of the living, my sadness to the moon. I haven't left my dance to the world. I am filled with regret. Translation, I am disappointed, O moon. I have died. Oh, I planned to bring the world together and stir it into a giant melting pot with my dance. If only I had taught my new dance to someone. Okay, the spirit dancer Kamaro was added to my notebook. Good, good, good. So what do we do? I'm no longer part of the living. I know. We've got the translation. You want to learn a new dance? For that, we teach you the Song of Healing. And he teaches us a really weird dance. It is Fondoshi, or whatever it's called. Spread my dance across the world, train its followers. Translation, I've taught it to you. Now make it into a popular dance craze. It's the locomotion, baby, but you got Kamaro's mask. Use it to teach his dance to the world, so his moves can become as popular as he'd hope they would be. Strange that it's kind of cut into that tiny little extra. I'm counting on you. Translation, I'm counting on you. Glad to know you became the dancer's successor. This was added to your notebook, the Song of Healing. It makes masks out of dead things. Hooray! What a nice thing. Anyway, onwards and upwards, back to town. For we know exactly who to train in the new dance sensation. To spread across the nation, come on baby, do Kamaro's dance. Up we go, move, move, move. And we need to head to the banker's district, which is not a bad idea in the first place, actually, because we actually have 196 rupees. So reaching the cap would not be exactly a great idea. We don't want to waste any rupees. We need to get something along the lines of thousands and thousands to get an extra heart piece just from the bank. We need thousands upon thousands, so that's going to be annoying to get, but someone who wants to learn how to dance, well, let us teach them the skills, the crazy, weird, Fondoshi-wearing dances. If that is a Fondoshi even. Would you like to learn, guys, as my face goes completely blank? It appears you're not interested. Until we target you specifically. Link actually looks really good doing that dance compared to them. He just looks crazy in his... Oh, guards like, what on earth is going on here? This is not a dance craze that will spread the nation. Thank you for teaching us those steps, no problem. You are a master. Master. And we get ourselves a piece of heart. We've assembled a new heart container. So we're now up to 7 hearts total. Great, you stole the hearts of the dancers! This was added to your notebook. No problem. Master, you're so cool, they love us. Link, you little player, you. 7 hearts at last, let's go. Back to the bunny mask, we don't move around so slow. And we don't want to check the sign, we want to talk to you, Mr. Banker. What's this, you need something? Deposit rupees, we'll deposit 96. Have a look at me all you like. Yes, Oliz, you remember us. 472 rupees is our current amount. Let's build that up a little bit more. 96. Would have been easier if I pressed down. We'll leave us with a square 100 for the mini games that are coming. No problemo, guys. Right then. We also have a moon's tear, if I remember correctly. So let's pick up our deed for the second. Moon, go, 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 go. Hello, sir. Sir. I keep hearing about a stone called a moon's tear, and it's supposed to be the shiniest stone in the world. You want it for your wife? We know. Let's go. Through the chat. And give you the moon's tear, sir. Now give us the Deku Land thing. Ah, that stone, you must give it to me. In exchange, I'll give you my spot here, and I'll throw in this Deku flower. Go, go, go! We got the land title deed yet again. Now fly off, sir. Before I kill you, or use the Song of Healing, and get an upgraded Deku head. It's unfair. Why do child Dekus not grow their cool helicopter heads and have to use flowers? Just think how easy this game would be if you could just fly everywhere. Which, you know, it's a good reason that Link is landlocked, let's say that. Oh, we didn't even have to do that in Deku Mask. I thought we'd have to do that in Deku Mask. I just did it. Okay, that's good knowledge for the future. He is not racist in any way, shape, or form. But someone said in the comments as well that I can blow up using the bomb mask the room with the room of knives, the room of blades, that crack in the wall. So, we're going to try that next. Don't need the mask of truth. Let's get up and going. Sleeping Goron nearby, who we conned out of a room. He's only there when we don't have the room after all. Or when we do have the room. We have access now. So let's head in. Bunny mask, go! Speed! I love this mask, it's amazing. And just think, they put Sprint finally in Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, as it were, but then gave it a stamina meter. This Link can go for miles and ever, forever and ever. He's Duracell Bunny Guy. Ooh, chest. Oh wow, we just filled up our rupees again. Silver rupees is 100. Pretty happy, yeah? So there's two chests for 100 rupees nearby in this place. There's nothing horrible still in the Room of Blades. It's just got a nasty name and no one really wants to stay in it. But we of course see this over here. What a ramshackle inn. Is this room first class? You can hear whoever's next door for crying out loud, can we? Well, whatever. We're staying for free, so we can't expect much. Nothing actually happens though. Bomb mask! Blow things up! Will it work? No, we cannot explode. There is no explode function. There's no way we're making it into the other room, it seems. And yes, I have heard in the comments multiple times that if I use the shield and then the bomb, we do not get hurt, we just get knocked back. Can't go in at night, because it says employees only. I could be an employee. Right then. The other things you guys have been saying is visit the toilet at night. Visit the toilet for a scary sight. Or talking of Skyward Sword, yet another guy that we met in that. The crazy hand. Paper, please! We'll give you paper. The land title deed.
Yay!
Ho! You saved me! And you flushed the loo, flushed the paper. This fell down here, I'll give it to you. I don't really want it. A heart piece that was in the bog. In the loo. Lush. Mmm. Tasty. Guess who? Well, that person was added to your notebook. You helped guess out of a jam. This was added to your notebook too. More things in the notebook. Bye, sir. Explode him. Explode him at once for his insolence. Is Granny still reading her books in here? She is indeed. Run away. It might be good to pass a few hours, because if I'm right in saying, the minigames will not be opening for a few hours at least. So maybe we can hop out. See the pun there with the bunny? Huh? Hop out. Oh, that was sad. And check out a bit more of Termina! He says, with cold filling his nose and certain pronunciations of words failing miserably. Mind you, I also have 200 rupees, so I actually should visit the bank. Well, 3 hours till the games begins, or it should be actually 2 hours from now. So, I think you guys have mentioned multiple times that I keep missing a heart piece on the way to the swamp in a tree somewhere that I miraculously managed to not see. And that I can get it. So, we'll go check that out. As soon as I've deposited my monies. I've already got 2 heart pieces this episode. One extra mask. We got rid of the land title deed. We might need that where we're going for the next dungeon. Okay, we want to deposit more rupees. Let's get to it. Check me, scan me. We've got a different mask on. Yes, Oliz. We're going to put even more rupees in. Yes, it's great. 100 rupees. 100. We really need to find out where the next wallet is. I'm sure you guys can give me that information. Let's head off towards the swamp. And look for yet another heart piece. It'd be nice if we could reach somewhere like 8 heart containers. We've got to, before we go next dungeon, we've got to do all the shooting minigames, the normal shooting minigames, again, with perfect scores to get another heart piece. So that's going to be a bit of a bother, I feel. There's a heart piece on each of those games, and it's going to be a bit meh to kind of get it in the end. It's not up this one, is it? No, nothing around here. It's further on in the swamp, I guess. Let's go check things out. Roll, Link, roll. Run with your bunny ears. So is it this tree? Oh, yeah, it's this tree. Okay, you can cover yourself up. Oh, there we go. I finally got you targeted. I'll sort you out, sir. Is it this tree? I'm sure we saw a blue little marker in that then. We've got the bow and arrow anyway, haven't we? So we can shoot down the crows at least. We've even got some arrows for it. Oh, there you are, sir. Okay, I was looking around everywhere for you. Couldn't see you at all. You gonna tap me? You disappeared, okay. It had to be a crow, didn't it? Or was it a bat? It's a key. Okay, I messed that up completely. Didn't have my sword out. There's another one. Ah, you stopped me killing the other one. One more bat around here. So supposedly we can climb this tree somehow. Oh, okay, there's actually vines there. So we definitely can climb the tree. It's just a bat in our way. So I thought this tree looked suspicious the first time. Obviously not for the same reason it actually was suspicious. Yet another heart piece free this episode so far. And of course, we're working on another 2 with the main mini-games that we're doing. So let's let the time pass now so we can get to 6 o'clock as soon as possible while we head into the main city, Clock Town, yet again. Okay, we'll return the flow of time to normal. We just want an hour to pass. So the next day finally begins. 3 heart pieces, lush, lush, lush. So thanks guys for all your comments as usual. They really help me out when I get round to actually like really getting to them. When the story's over, as it were, when the dungeons are done, I kind of usually have quite a few comments from you that I can actually mine out and use so we can find nice locations and do lots of lovely things and get lots of lovely heart pieces. I really would like the 8th heart before we head off to the next dungeon, that's for sure. Definitely the 2 games we are approaching, with the 3-day quest as it were, will provide us one of them. Well, will provide us 2 of them, so we will get to that 8th heart container. There's still another 2 hearts that we can get just from completing the arrow games yet again. Anyway, the time, the screen shrinks. Time changes. And a new day is dawning. It's kind of a cool effect that a game actually used something like that. I can't remember another game using a shrinking screen. Dawn of the second day. Let's freeze our time again, or at least let's slow it down. Invert the time, we will indeed slow it down by half. Let's get working. Darling and honey shop, honey and darling. Stop dancing, we've got games to play. It looks like we have a visitor, honey. I wonder if it's a customer, darling. Oh, are you the one who got a perfect score yesterday? Would you like to play again? Today is basket bomb day, isn't it, darling? I'll play. 10 rupees is cheap. Get a bomb inside every basket and the time it takes us to dance through one song. Different kind of bombs. If you throw with too much power, you'll fall off this platform, so be careful, right, darling? So make sure not to run off, because the rule of bombs, of course, if you stand still, you plant it, so we actually have to be very mobile and make sure we worry about that edge. Dance, guys, dance! Dance for me! And I will try to basket these bombs. And fail miserably at it. Right, get in! Good, we saved ourselves there. It's a bit easier now, because bomb shoes, for example, was a bit harder considering the fact that... Oh, get in there before you blow. Yes, cool. The platform itself would deviate the target. Oh, no, this is bad. Quickly get in. Yes, we got... Okay, where's the last one? Okay, we got to rotate it ourselves. Get in! That game isn't even hard! Perfect, we know! Honey and darling, that game was actually quite easily, because the platform didn't affect really anything at all. Do you see that, honey? You got a perfect score! We have to share our happiness with him, honey. Give me some more rupees then! Another 50! Thank you, guys! That's annoying, so let's show off even more for him, darling! With kissing and love and affection! But of course, we will visit them for the third day to complete the quest chain, so to say. Now, however, Deku Playground was the other one we were doing. We may have to skip some time soon as well. This is a mini-game extravaganza we've been doing lately. Shooting games and everything, a whole day of shooting games. Now various other games going on as well. However, how this one might change might lead to multiple tries, and like the last one, which was really easy. We only did this one with split second remaining, if I'm correct. Let's give this one try before the episode ends. I know we're near to our allotted timers, so to say. And here we go. Day 2 of the Deku Playground. Wake up, guys. We've got multiple moving, fast platforms. Nasty. Try setting a new record again today, young Oliz. We will. Alright then, use this Deku Flower and have fun. We will do. If the time it takes you to get all the rupees is faster than the current record, you get an extravagant prize, which should probably be 50 rupees. If you fall down below once it's over. The best time for today's game is 1 minute 15. We'll do that. Okay, we're going. So when we let go is when it's done, isn't it? Let's just examine the platforms a second. So they all just go around in a circle on their squares. So we're going to have to hit the outside ones after making a foray into the center from the outside edge. This is going to hurt. Yes, I thought that might mess up. Okay, we've got to get the platforms judged right. We'll play again. Because I failed that quite extravagantly there. Let's go! Try setting a new record, we will! Last try for the episode. Which is only the second try. That first try was just a test to find out exactly how fast the platforms move, so to say. we should blast off about nowish then. Oh, those platforms move fast. Now we're actually on one. It should be significantly easier, he says. Not so sure of himself right now. Oh my goodness gracious. Ha! Failure yet again. Too bad, you're done. I overshot the platform I wanted, and it was just, terrible. Okay, we can repeat as many times. If we have the rupees, we have the rupees. We'll have to continue this next episode, guys. Maybe I'll start it off straight away with a winning try rather than endless tries of failure. So thank you for watching. Join me next time for more, and I'll see you guys around. Bye-bye.